Good evening. Today is going to be an ultra short presentation. It's going to be a single disease called as sweat dermatitis. This is a new entity. It hasn't got into international literature yet, although it is there in journals published in India and from India. And the classic Indian Journal of Dermatology, Venereology and Dermatology and IJDVL and the International Journal of Dermatology have carried articles on this. What is sweat dermatitis? Sweat dermatitis is an irritant contact dermatitis caused by sweat. How does it occur? When the skin that is soaked in sweat comes into contact with the sweat-soaked skin, it causes irritant contact dermatitis on prolonged exposure to sunlight and in hot and humid climates, as we are now undergoing in Chennai. So this gentleman who saw me about 3 weeks ago with a lesion like this on the forehead, the lesions as we see are scaly and are located on the forehead and also on the upper back. The history is that this gentleman, whose occupation is that of a small-term businessman, he goes from shop to shop selling his homemade murukku and is on the road from 7 in the morning for the entire day till about 9 in the night, and this happens every day of the year. So he wears a handkerchief tied onto the forehead to prevent the sunlight from attacking his skin, and he also wears a shirt which gets soaked and is stuck to the skin. And a prolonged contact with a sweat-soaked shirt causes this sweat dermatitis, where there is a peeling of the superficial layer of the skin minus inflammation. There is absolutely no inflammation. The lesions do not cause any itching at all, and the only symptom is mild burning. And after a few weeks' time, the superficial layer completely peels off to be replaced by normal skin. But the whole thing is going to repeat because this man has got no other occupation. He'll be on the road every day of the year, and Chennai is not going to get any cooler. Thank you.
What is the treatment?
Yeah, treatment is just applying emollients. What we do is either liquid paraffin or plain coconut oil, sir.
Or taking once, thrice a day, will it
help? Yeah, it does help, sir.
What is the difference? Seborrheic and sweat dermatitis? Is it the same? Seborrheic dermatitis?
No, they are not the same, sir.
What is the difference? I mean, clinically.
So, clinically, the scaling in seborrheic dermatitis will be on the forehead, on the ears, and on the eyebrows are there, where there is a lot of sweat glands and sebaceous glands. Whereas in sweat dermatitis, it is seen in predominantly in the trunk, because the all of us wear shirts which are clinging to the skin on exposure to sunlight for long periods, and there are no sebaceous glands on the trunk. This gentleman had an unusual location of sweat dermatitis on the forehead because he is used to wear a handkerchief all the time. So this location is a little unusual, but the lesions are typical sweat dermatitis.
Most of the girls nowadays wear almost everything like a terrorist. Do they have that?
depends on how long they are going to expose to sunlight.
Very loosely, that is worn very loosely. That's here the headband like that is constant and with a little of firm contact. That
yes.
is the cuffs.
Plus,
even around the neck also, it will be a very firm contact. Once the sweat that completely filling over, that will be very extreme closeness.
The duration also matters.
Yeah, that again.
Because if you, maybe if you are in the sun for about 20 minutes
yes.
and even if you wear a tight shirt, nothing is going to happen. If you are on the road for about 10-12 hours a day
exactly.
and then every day of the week, you are asking for trouble.
Mm.
Now I request Dr. Devan, a senior pediatrician, to come forward to hand over the certificate of appreciation to Dr. B. Srinivas.
Thank you.